Hello, welcome to Enops Engineering. I'm Alan. Over the last few weeks I've been doing some milling and I've taken the edge off my tools. So what I thought I'd do today is with the cutter grinder and the indexing fixture is re-grind the end of this end mill so that I can get a better finish. So let's go into the workshop, see how I do it. I'll start off today by dressing this wheel. So the first thing I've done is fit the vacuum hose so any bits that are in this area will be sucked behind the wheel into the hose. I'm putting this tray, which is an ice cream tub lid, it's got some oil in it, and I just place that underneath the wheel so any bits of grit as it's ground will be forced down and it'll catch on the oil, so it reduces the bits of dust and grit that are floating around. I've fitted this diamond for dressing the wheel into the holder. So when dressing, I want the wheel to be coming, if it's on this side, I want the wheel to come down so it's pressing down on the table. And if it's on this side, I want it to go the other way so it's pressing down. The idea of that is you're not lifting the table up with the wheel. And when you're taking a cut on a tool, you do the same thing. You're pressing the table down so it gets a firm base so you get a steady and fine cut. Now I've got some suction coming through around the side of this wheel. I'll switch on the wheel and feed in the diamond till it touches. Don't forget to wear safety specs. I've disconnected the vacuum hose. I only use that when I'm dressing the wheel because you get a lot of grit. And we've now finished with the diamond. So I can undo the what I want to do today is have a go at grinding the edge of this end mill. I've marked it with red felt tip pen so we can see the faces. I've not got a way yet of grinding the sides, but with these end mills I use the ends more than the sides for feeding into something or milling a flat face. So the sides are still sharp on this. So I'll take this fixture off because I need to put one with a collet on that I can index. Just a little tip, I keep my tools and fixtures in these ice cream tubs that have a clear plastic lid, and I write on the end what is in the tub. That keeps the dust, dirt, damp off it, and you can stack these up on a shelf. This is the indexing fixture I made with the pin. The pin locates in the hole. Screw goes through here, and this little nut has a little pin in it that stops it turning. That goes in the slot that goes on this radius. This will lock the fixture. Got my position mark in there, so move that round to zero. Lock it up so it's square to the wheel. And to fit the cutter, I've got an ER20 collet with a half inch bore that fits in the end. There's two things I want to do, obviously move the table back so the cutter will go in front of the wheel. I've got a 5 degree angle on the table, so it's actually 5 degrees up like that. What I want to do is grind this side of the cutter, so I'm grinding this side. So to do that I need to get this cutter square so that the faces are square at the moment. They're not, so by turning it round in the collet, and by putting the rule across the cutting edge of the tool, I can then align the edge of this edge of the rule with the table. That's about right. Tighten up the collet. It doesn't have to be really tight, it's not as if I'm machining with it. Each side of the table I've got these stops that I can slide along. I'll just slide it to the position and lock it with the brass screw, and that will then stop me going any further across than that stop. I've adjusted the arm so it's central with this pin underneath, so the lever fits into that fork. Now I can move it up to the top. So now when I move my table across, it stops where the stop is, and this wheel should just be in the centre, the edge of this wheel should just be in the centre of the tool. This is the feed to put the cut on. Table set at 5 degree tilt. So I want to wind it in until it just touches the wheel and see how it's cutting. Each time I lift the table, I'll index the cutter to the next face in this way. So I'll lift this up, undo the locking screw for the indexing, index it round to the next facet, lock the locking screw up for the indexing, then lower it back down, and I haven't put a cut on. You can see on this that as I index it, the screw here stays still, this part rotates, so I'm not feeding the tool into the wheel unless I turn this. Feed in. Now you can see I've just taken a cut on there. I've adjusted the table angle to 8 degrees. Because of the angles changed, I have to feed the table in a bit further. After a quick clean up to get the red marks off, I've noticed one of the facets has got a little chip in it, but that should come out next time I sharpen it. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enuts Engineering.